Good morning. This is Sunday, August the 1st, and we're on our way to church. We're here at church, ready to go in. It's Monday morning. Time to take out the trash.
There it is.
That's our second bag. The first one we took to the landfill, I think, Thursday.
Run you over. Bye.
Bye. Have fun.
Fun.
Larry's off the shuffleboard, but he's not going to go play with the group. He's going to teach his friend how to play. This is 11:45 on Monday, August the 2nd, and it is 66 degrees. I got the leather britches out. I'm going to soak them in water overnight, and we'll try eating them tomorrow and see if we like them. Here's my beans after soaking all night. It doesn't look too promising. This is our leather britches after they were cooked. Larry liked them okay. I'm just going to try them. Well, I think they're okay. They'd be good in emergency situations, but I wouldn't want them every day. And I think they'd be better too if the beans were younger when we picked them and strung them. But they still taste pretty good. We got a nice tomato growing there and a few others, and we picked more squash, and it's still making more squash. And turns out these bell peppers are petite. They're supposed to be small. I think were they petite bell, the name of them?
Yeah.
And we picked enough beans for lunch. I noticed this when I was out walking a couple days ago and thought it was interesting. So I brought my camera today. It's growing here. This is Saturday, August the 7th, and the beef that we got here was so good we came back to get some more today. They have a lot of hay put up for the cows. Big bales. Well, we got our meat and we're leaving. It's 9:28 and 64 degrees.
Yeah, I started having a tough time with it.
That's why I have a tough time about life.
It's the Blue Ridge Horse Pullers Association. They've got booths set up way over there and food. There's some more pretty horses. They're all pretty. Strong looking. Oh, wow.
Thank you, guys.
Lining up the horses, so here comes some more. Enjoying some leaves off the tree. Thank you.
playing of the national anthem. The completed poll for LW Colton's team with Ricky Phipps doing the driving. Odell Coley's up. A completed full poll is 27 and a half feet. They get 3 attempts to pull at the full amount, but you do not add the distances together. So you've got 3 attempts to pull a full pull of 27 and a half feet.
And it's 4,000 pounds.
Completed pull for Dave Easter. All the light weights across, 4,000 pounds.
They're putting more blocks on, more weight, another 1,000 pounds.
You spectators, if you have a chance to support any of our sponsors, we would appreciate it.
These horses just don't pay any attention to what they're supposed to do.
Nope, they just want to talk to people.
This team of horses weighs over 5,000 pounds, and they've got little bits in their mouth, so imagine they're getting really amped up to get hooked on.
We got 2 people pulling. These are all Belgian horses. I said this is the tallest horse in the world. Make it 8,000 pounds on there to pull. Busting
it. It's not starting to get heavy, it is heavy. I can't pull 8,000 pounds. All the way for LW Care.
This is my first time I've ever been to a horse pull. There's 8,500 pounds on there now. Horses just do this for fun during the week. They're pulling logs and plowing and things like that, but they're working every day.
When the horses pull the sleds, it puts grooves in the ground, and the men are out there trying to level out the ground for them.
£9,000.
He had a good jump.
This is a big pair.
9,000 pounds. Like it pulls over just in time. That's a dark cloud back there. This is Sunday the 8th, and it's 7:48 a.m. and 56 degrees. We're going back to South Carolina. Mary's got a doctor's appointment tomorrow. It's 2:05 and 88 degrees. When we turned on to our road, it was 91. And we are home.
Grass needs mowing.
This is why we came back to South Carolina. Larry's got an appointment there with the Berkeley Medical Complex for his defibrillator for his heart. And this is Monday the 9th of August. This is Monday afternoon, about 4 o'clock, and the temperature's gone down to 96 degrees. It was about 98. Larry's supposed to be mowing in the shade. His doctor this morning said he had atrial flutter, so they're going to do an ablation on his heart. But they got to call back and set up the appointment for that. So with the atrial flutter, it doesn't beat regular, it just kind of flutters. The ablation, I think, is supposed to fix it. It'll probably be done in September. They said the atrial flutter had been going on since about April and just kind of constant, so it affects his quality of life. So that's why they're going to do it, see if they can fix it. I came out this morning and got the pine straw all raked off the roof. There's a leak right there that Larry's planning on patching. Gonna put a piece of metal over it.
I'm bleeding somehow.
Touched the metal. Well, not the best view. I guess I'll turn the camera off.
Yeah.
Well, we got it on here. We're going to get another shorter piece and put up here so it'll overlap, but not this morning. This is Tuesday, and I came over to Betty's to mow, and Larry came too, and he burned this big old brush pile. So he's gone now, and I'm just going to keep an eye on it from the house and pour water all over it before I leave. But it's doing pretty good. And he had the hose out. And I got the backyard all mowed. Now I'm inside at Betty's, and she's having, what are you having, lemonade or coffee?
Coffee.
It's morning, coffee. Still coffee.
And my Biscoff.
And your Biscoff cookies, and are they gone?
They're gone.
Okay. And reading your book.
And you can have some if you like.
I think I'm going to go change my clothes and get cleaned up. This is Wednesday, August the 11th, and we put the other piece of sheet metal on the roof this morning. So now it overlaps the bottom piece and should work fine. And Larry scraped the pine straw off the rest of the roof down there. And we already did these two roofs yesterday. We just have to be slow and take our time when you're old. I got the weeds out of the coreopsis. There was so many there you couldn't even see the flowers. But I got them uncovered again. And the zinnias are done for. They're all dying. I think the sweet potatoes may have grown since I watered them Monday. Just a little bit. I watered them again just now. Barbara came over and we played cards. Played canasta. And I won! Yay! It was fun. It was good to see her after. Hadn't seen her for a while. Have to get caught up. This is Thursday the 12th of August. It's 7:03 in the morning. And 77 degrees, and we're leaving the South Carolina heat behind.
It's 8:07. We've been across the road to get Hardy's breakfast. And now we're sitting here at the post office waiting to say hi to Larry's daughter, Tammy.
Hello.
Hey, I know y'all coming back.
We're going back.
Oh.
We've been here since Sunday.
Oh. If I known that, I would have called you. We need a metal detector. Michael don't know how to use Chris's. It beeps at everything.
Don't know how? Oh.
We're trying to find the marker in Lodge.
Oh, okay.
The corner marker.
Well, we're up here in the mountains picking string beans.
We already put a bunch of them in the truck.
And squash. She's still picking beans. And we've already put something in the truck.
It's 1:30 and time for Larry to go to shuffleboard, but we're getting a really good storm. I think there might have been some hail. Lightning and thunder. I don't want to go out on the porch. Lightning is bad. We was going to take the golf cart, but that's not such a good idea now. It's slacked up just a little bit. So he's gonna go see if anybody else is gonna go play shuffleboard. It's 3:15 and the rain's over and the sun's out. We're back here at the Patio Grill. Elvis and Dolly Parton's supposed to be here tonight. So we're gonna get us a BLT and listen to the music a little while. Larry's going up to get a sandwich. Here comes Larry with our food.
Almost didn't make it up there.
There's even more people. There's more golf carts coming all the time.
Well, they don't do you any good stuck in the car. Somebody's got a fuss at you.
Okay, I'll give you a little piece of advice. If you want to get on Elvis's good side, listen to me. Just tell him how much cuter I am than he is.
Pleasure to be here. Hey, what about Dolly Parton, everybody? All right, we're going to do some Elvis songs, believe it or not.
You an Elvis fan?
Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much.
What's your Elvis?
All right, we're going to do a song. Well, this is Proud Mary. I left a good job in the city, working for the man every night and day. Saw one minute of sleeping, worried about the way things might have been. Big wheels keep on turning, Proud Mary keep on burning. You know I'm rolling, rolling, rolling on the river. I pushed a lot of pay down in Memphis, pushed a lot of pay down in New Orleans, but I never saw the good side of the city till I hitched a ride on the riverboat queen. I'll tell you, big wheels keep on turning. I want to stay around you, and so I beg you, let it be me. Don't take this heaven from one. If you must cling to someone now and forever,
and blue. Glory, glory, hallelujah. His truth is marching on. His truth is marching on.
One more that wasn't.
We came here to Tennessee. Larry brought some of his stuff to try to get rid of. And there's hardly anybody here. Just his horse stuff. We've been here about 2 hours. There's just two other people down there that are selling. It's pretty here. So how much did you make? How much did you make?
Well, I made $2.
Uh-huh.
And paid $5 for the table.
Uh-huh.
So what does that tell you? Minus $3.
You lost $3. Okay. And we had a nice morning here for 2 hours.
Well, we won't come here no more.
This is Saturday afternoon and it's raining again. It started about 2:15. 2:30. Seems to be a repeat of yesterday, only not quite so much. It's Sunday the 15th of August and we're here for church. Not too many cars yet, we're a little early. It's 5 o'clock and 70 degrees. I don't think anything else is going to happen today except maybe another storm. So I'll say good night. God bless.